Okay, we should be back. So let's get started with Rescue Rangers. Regarded as another classic of the NES era. It actually has, yeah, it's known for having a two-player co-op, which is pretty cool. Zero's Story has that one character, yes. The X-Fan's waifu. Okay. So, quite a bit different gameplay style than DuckTales, but still pretty good. To be perfectly honest, I'm not as fluent with this game as I am with DuckTales. So we'll see if everyone's okay, Zip, you can Zip gives us invincibility. And kills everything on the screen. Yeah, I hear doggy. Well, hey! Forgot that, okay, the middle boxes we want to hold on to since they don't disappear after throwing them, but I can't throw them as far either. Bees! Not the bees! Okay, Jack just burst through the wall like the Kool-Aid Man. And here we fight the boss. Should be a relatively easy, easy boss. As long as I don't beam myself with my own projectiles. There we go. Oh boy, Gadget has been reduced to damsel in distress in this game, then. Hey! Jerk. Yeah, like I said, this game has two-player co-op, so that's also something to watch out for, is friendly fire. If you beam your partner with a projectile, it doesn't actually hurt him, but it stuns him for a second. Whoa, hey. Watch your back. I have to watch it because I don't have a lot of health and, crap. And there's not, this game doesn't give a lot of opportunities to fill up. I think you get either health or one-ups by collecting enough of those flower things. Oh! Okay, jump right in there. That's... I guess, Chipmunk Stew's on the menu tonight. Okay, there we go. I think once you get enough flowers, that appears that gives you a one-up. Sure. Oh my. Oh my god. They just give me a constant stream of those things. As I'm trying to... precarious jumps with that. Where is he? Okay, so that time he didn't show up. Is that a full health thing? Oh, here's the... Oh, there's the flying bastard again. Oh my... Yep, I know about the Steam sale going on now. In fact, this game was marked down as part of the Steam sale, so, that was what gave me the idea to get it, and, like I said, I did want to stream this, this compilation. And so going on sale gave me a good excuse to, do precisely that. Out of here. Oh my god. clown shirts. Having none of that. Wow. Like I said, I'm not as proficient in this game as I am with some of the other games in this collection. So, I'm actually not sure if I'm gonna finish this game. I've honestly never beaten this game legit. I've gotten up until like the last level. That's where they really start. That's where the game really starts getting to be a jerk. Ah, you're welcome, Scarlet. Okay, now get by this guy again. There we go. Yeah, definitely. Oh my! Jeez, you have a big hitbox. Yeah, there's still plenty of sprite flicker in this. Again, it's pretty much... Overall, it's looking to be like a pretty direct emulation. Let's take the high road this time. Well, hey. Oh. Okay, Rock Hawk. Oh, jeez. Jeez. This is a long level. Yeah, I hear that's everyone's biggest complaint about Infinite, is just, I guess they don't like the graphics. Okay, we got this super fighting robot. We just have to hit the lights on its chest. Which, it's looking like it's easier said than done. Pretty small area to hit. Looks like there's consistently a one-up on that top box, which again is a good thing considering how I've been playing at this game. Chun-Li got especially bad in Infinite. Well, I mean, well, Chun-Li has pretty much been a given in almost every Capcom versus somebody crossover, along with Ryu. Okay, get out of here, Rock Hawk. Oh boy, yeah, I remember this. Oh god, yeah, this part. It's like, it's almost like the Yoku blocks. Can I get up here? There we go. Okay. Yeah, it's one of those deals where when you scroll up, it doesn't scroll back down, so if you fall off screen, you just die. But fortunately, there's no boss fight in this level. Yeah, Kid Icarus, that whole thing was a big problem in that game. I died so much in Kid Icarus because of that. Yeah, there's plenty of that in Contra also. Okay. Sure. Oh, jeez, I didn't realize those bombs actually... Yeah, pro tip, bombs explode. Thanks. Yeah, well... I guess if you hold on to it for too long... Yeah, this is Chip. Yeah, they seem to be... The way they seem to be, based is, Yeah, Chip wears the jacket and the fedora, which is, reminiscent of Indiana Jones, while Dale wears that Hawaiian shirt, kind of like, Magnum P.I. Okay, the dick just, double-hit me. which is actually kind of interesting from a, I don't know, sort of a meta perspective, I guess, because as, I'm not sure how many people are aware, but, when George Lucas did Indiana Jones, his first choice for the role was actually, Tom Selleck, who played, Magnum P.I., but, he turned the role down because he was, that's what he was working on at the time, and so, Lucas fell back on, his boy, Harrison Ford. So having two characters based on those two characters, I just thought that was kind of neat. Great animation there. Bubble crab. Freaking bubble crab. Kind of sucks that I can't drop through platforms while holding something. That's actually been causing a bit of problems for me. Whoa. Okay. Flying ninja squirrel. Yeah, this music is, it's recycled. Pretty- oh! You dick. Oh. Oh god, I'm all the way back here again. I hate you, bubble crab. No, there's the one up. Get that. Thank you. There we go. Yeah, there is a bit of checkpoint starvation here. I knew he was there too, I just missed him. What? Man, I don't know, I'm probably just underestimating, like, my, my mercy invincibility there. Right, that, yeah, I know. I keep thinking I should be able to just run through, but no. Health right there where I don't need it. Then how many lives I have? I know I did lose quite a few in that area. And either I don't recall if this is like DuckTales where when it's game over, it's game over. Or, if you have limited continues. But for that reason, I probably shouldn't skimp on the flowers here. Okay, at least the game's merciful enough to give you all those flowers. Oh, and no boss fight, either. Okay, jeez. Oh yeah, these pelican guys, I think you... Oh, okay. I think sometimes you throw stuff at them and they'll swallow it and, yeah, they'll throw it back. Can't jump over them either. That's great. I know, right? The developers really love this music, apparently. Big hitbox, too. how you deal with Pelican Bastard. Oh! Whoa! Okay, the dick can even do that if you hit him from the back. That's terrific. Man, what the hell? Man, even when I'm ready for that, I still get hit anyways. Okay, Pelican dick. You can suck it, okay? And that time I overcompensated for the fan. Again, I don't know how I'm supposed to deal with you. Oh, there we go. Okay, the fan's not affecting me from there. Oh, now it is. Oh, jeez. And now Pelican Dick is in my way. He's just gonna throw it back. Game, please. Maybe I just don't know how to deal with them, but... Jeez. Yeah, oh yeah, maybe that is what I have to do. I just have to get up really close to him. I can't attack him from a distance. No. That's some pretty dick placement, though. Nope, I'm right up in the guy's... I'm right up in his face. Yeah, I have a feeling that this is about as far as I'm gonna make in this game. I think this was as far as I made it originally as well. I might have made it to the final area before finally not being able to do it because that level's hard too. Hell. Yeah, I know, right? Ugh. All all Fat Cat really needs is his Pelicans of Doom, yes. Right, okay, yeah, ain't duh. Just aim for the legs instead of the head. That should be kind of obvious then. Thank you, Zip. Yes, sweet invincibility and light. Okay, now for the boss, we fight Mr. Centipede Guy. Bosses in this game are concerned, I actually consider him probably the hardest though. Because of that whole thing where he breaks apart is kind of hard to avoid. There we go. Okay. Again, I remember having a really hard time on this level also. There's so much shit, and there's that checkpoint starvation that hits you too. Rangers was pretty popular in Russia then? Huh. Oh yeah, this part. This was the part that always killed me. These stupid weasels. They shoot, and these lizard fedora guys. They shoot before I can react, so I would always take cheap hits from them. We'll be right back. then again, with the checkpoint starvation, which... Oh! You son of a bitch. What the hell just happened there? And now I'm just falling through the floor at random. That's terrific. I mean, this segment's generous with the health. Not so much for this area. Okay, this part's not too bad. Again, it's pretty much this little gauntlet right here. I'm not quite sure how to deal with this. They all shoot before I have a chance to react. And they start you all the way back here. What kind of enemy would make this lovely do worse? Take a guess. I would say jetpack assholes. Okay, I kind of just kind of had to brute force my way through that part. Oh no, 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 no. Okay. Can you give me some health, game? Some health would be much appreciated. Is this the final? Oh, yes, it is. Okay. And... Oh, that was sad. That was just sad. But I can apparently do it. I just have to do it with some lives remaining. I just have to... Oh, no, I'm gonna die. Damn it! Do I just not know the right way to do that? Again, it feels like I gotta just try to brute force my way through and try to get through before I just die. I'm not sure if there's a better way through that. Then again, can I just duck to get past that? No, I can't duck under them either. So yeah, it is just a matter of brute forcing through it. Yeah, that's what I tried to do, but ducking didn't work either. That works to an extent, but then, yeah, it doesn't... But there's not really enough time to capitalize. We'll be right back. Okay, that at least worked. Okay, I just have to deal with that cat, which... Oh! And then... Okay. Just don't get greedy. Ah, there we go! Damn! Man, that final approach is brutal. Like I implied earlier, it's like the jetpack assholes in TMNT in that final approach to the final boss there. Okay, but we did it. Nice. So that was Rescue Rangers 1. Let's see, what game is next? Ah, Tailspin is next. Okay, give me just a sec, I'll be right back.